an ellipse or inscribe an ellipse. An ellipse. In a parallelogram, of size 170 mm into 130 mm or 120 mm, let us say 120 mm, having included angle of 75 degree, and locate major axis and minor axis. These are the problems which may be asked in your exam. Okay, it will be asked for 10 marks. This comes under unit 2. So today we are completing unit 2 and we will start unit 3 from next class. So construct an ellipse or inscribe an ellipse in a parallelogram of size 170 mm into 120 mm. Having included angle of 75 degree, and also locate major axis and minor axis. Let us see how to solve this problem. It is almost like what we did for rectangle method, right? Rectangle method, in rectangle we did know. The same method we have to follow, but only we are inscribing it in a parallelogram, right? Parallelogram will inscribe martivasta. Procedure all same, dividing lines, intersection of lines, all are same. This is intersecting lines method. This method is also called as intersecting lines method. Okay, intersecting lines method. Let us solve this problem. First, let us construct a parabola of size 170 mm into 120 mm having included angle of 75 degree. First, draw a line of length equal to 170 mm. Right? Then, measure an included angle of 75 degree, right? This side and also 75 degree on this side. 75 degree. Then join this. Along this line, locate 120 mm. Along this line, locate 120 mm. Here also, locate 120 mm. Measure this length as 120 mm. Join this. And this is a parallelogram of length 170 mm this side and side 120 mm and included angle. This angle is 75 degree. Call this as PQRS. And let us do the dimension for this. This length is 170 mm. And this side I have to locate. This is 120 mm. Now, how do you carry out the construction here? Divide this into two halves. Locate the axis first. Divide this into two halves. You can't locate axis initially itself. After construction of ellipse, you have to locate the axis. Initially, you divide this into two parts. Similarly, here is 170 mm. So 85 is the midpoint. 85 is the midpoint here. Join these two. Call it as A, B, C, and D. Right? Now I have divided this into four parts. Midpoint. I joined the midpoints of these two and I joined the midpoints of these two. Wherever the point coincide, we call it as O. Let this O be the line of intersection. Now divide AS into four parts. I mean, this is 60, 15. 15, 15 you can divide, because already you know it is 60 here. Right? Since it is 60 here, 15, 15, 15, 15 you can take. Here also you can take it as 15, 15. Because already you know the dimension here, this is 60. Hence it is easy to divide this into four parts. Otherwise, you have to do this method. So lines in that the parallel lines you have to draw on that, you have to do using that method. You also divide this into four parts. Okay. Call this as 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash. Same method. What you did for rectangle, the same way you have to do here, 2 dash, 3 dash. Now divide AO into 4 parts. Now I have divided all this into 4 parts. Now AO you divide into 4 parts. How to divide AO into 4 parts? This is 85, you can't divide by that method. You have to go for this method only. Draw a line of any length. Measure 20 mm. Call it as 1, 2, 3, 4. Join 4 with O and draw a line parallel to 4O. Similarly, call this as 3 dash, 2 dash, 1 dash. Now the transfer this distance onto the other side of the now do you transfer this O 3 dash, whatever the length you have, you transfer to this side. Okay, see here, it is exactly equal. All lines are equal. Call this as a 3 dash, 2 dash, 1 dash. Now this procedure is over. Next, what we have to do? See here, students, all this line should be thin. Okay, all construction lines should be thin. Intersecting lines all should be thin. Otherwise, you can't able to locate the parabola. You can't visible. It won't be visible. Right? You have to make all the lines thin using 2H pencils. Wherever you want to draw thin lines, use 2H pencils. Wherever you have to draw thick line, use 2B pencils. Right? Now, let us solve this method. Join D3 dash and extend what we did in the previous case, the same way. Join D2 dash and extend. Join D1 dash and extend. Similarly here, join D3 dash, extend. Join to D2 dash and extend. Join D1 dash and extend it. Right? Similarly, join C3 dash. Join C2 dash, join C1 dash. Right? Now join C3 dash, join C2 dash, join C1 dash. Right? Call this names. So D1 dash and C1 dash, call it as P1. D2 dash and C2 dash, D2 dash extended and C2 dash, call it as P2. D3 dash and C3 dash, P3. Similarly, this side, D3 dash and C3 dash, P3. D2 dash and C2 dash, P2. C1 dash and C1 dash, D1 dash extended and C1 dash, P3. Right? Now we got P1, P2, P3. P3, P1. Sorry, this is P1, P2, P3. Same procedure you have to follow to the below. Join C3 dash and extend it. Join C2 dash and extend it. Join C1 dash and extend it. Similarly, join C1 dash and extend. Join C2 dash and extend. Join C1 dash and extend. Sorry, join C3 dash and extend. 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, C3 dash, C2 dash, C1 dash. Next, join D1 dash, join D2 dash, join D3 dash. Similarly, this side, join D1 dash, join D2 dash, and join D3 dash. Now, C1 dash extended, D1 dash, they are meeting here, call it as P1. C2 dash and C21 dash extended, call it as P2. C3 dash and D3 dash, P3. Similarly here, this will be P1, P2 and P3. That is C3 dash and D3 dash, P3, P2, P1. Right? Now all these points you have to locate it by a smooth curve first. I will start from A. A, P1 dash, P2 dash, P3 dash, C, C23, P3, P2, P1. You can see here, you should touch B. All these lines should touch B. Once again, P1, P2, P3. Similarly, this side. Touching P1, P2, P3, and then D. Similarly, D and P3 have to join. So you have to join like this, right? After joining this, darken this by means of a 2B pencil. Right? This is how we have drawn the parabola. Understood? Okay, let us locate the major axis and minor axis. Here there is two part of problem. First part is construction of parabola. Second part is locating the major axis and minor axis. Listen students, let us see how to locate major axis and minor axis. You have to follow the same procedure. What you have to do here? Let O be the center of the compass. Place the compass pointer at O. With O as center, OC as radius. Listen here. O as center, OC as radius. Okay. O as center, OC as radius. Draw an arc. Okay. Draw an arc touching the parabola. See here. O as center, OC as radius, draw an arc. This arc is going to touch the parabola at one point. Call that point where this arc, you can see this arc which I have drawn. So, how to draw this arc? With O as center, OC as radius, draw an arc. This arc is going to touch the ellipse at one point. Call this point as M. Right? Next, join CM. Understood? So, join CM. And for this CM, now you have CM. For this CM, you have to draw perpendicular bisector. CM. ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಲ್ಲ ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ಸಿ ಇಂದ ಏನು ಆರ್ಕ್ ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಅದು ಎಲಿಪ್ಸ್ನ ಒಂದು ಪಾಯಿಂಟಲ್ಲಿ ಕಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅದು ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಯಾವುದು ಎಮ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಈ ಸಿ ಎಮ್ನ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಒಂದು ಲೈನ್ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ಸಿ ಎಮ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲೈನ್ ಸಿ ಎಮ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡ್ರಾ ಪರ್ಪೆಂಡಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಬೈಸೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಹೌ ಟು ಡ್ರಾ ಪರ್ಪೆಂಡಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಬೈಸೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸಿ ಎಮ್ ಯು ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಆನ್ ಸಿ ಎಮ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸಿ ಎಮ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡ್ರಾ ಪರ್ಪೆಂಡಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಬೈಸೆಕ್ಟರ್ Take more than half and draw two arcs. Right? Similarly, with C as center, don't change the radius, same radius. Draw two arcs. So, what I did from M as center, take more than half and cut two arcs. Okay? Don't change the radius. The same radius with C as center, cut two arcs. Okay? ಎರಡು ಆರ್ಕ್ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಹೀಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲೊಂದು ಇಲ್ಲೊಂದು ನಾವು ಜಾಯಿನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟು ಆರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟು ಆರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಎರಡು ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಡ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನಾವು ದಿಸ್ ಲೈನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಾಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಮೇಜರ್ ಆಕ್ಸಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಮೇಜರ್ ಆಕ್ಸಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ EF. Now EF is major axis. Now I have to locate minor axis, right? Major axis ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಲ್ಲ ಹೇಗೆ ಮಾಡೋದು ಅಂತ CM. C ಇಂದ M ಗೆ ಒಂದು ಆರ್ಕ್ ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡಿ ಓ ಎಸ್ ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಓ ಸಿ ಎಸ್ ರೇಡಿಯಸ್ ಡ್ರಾ ಎನ್ ಆರ್ಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ಕ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಟಚ್ ದ ಎಲಿಪ್ಸ್ ಅಟ್ ಎಮ್ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಸಿ ಎಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡ್ರಾ ಪರ್ಪೆಂಡಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಬೈಸೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸಿ ಎಮ್ this perpendicular bisector this perpendicular bisector you extend ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಟಚ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ನೋಡಿ ಯಾವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಎಲಿಪ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಇ ಮತ್ತು ಎಫ್ ಅನ್ನೋ ಪಾಯಿಂಟಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಪಾಯಿಂಟಲ್ಲಿ ಟಚ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಎಲಿಪ್ಸ್ಗೆ ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ಇ ಎಫ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಮೇಜರ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಮೆಜರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ 175 mm Now I have to locate the minor axis. All of you listen here. To locate minor axis, what you have to do? Take your protractor, place the protractor at O point, right? The center of the protractor and O both should coincide. Draw 90 degree. Using your mini drafter, it is very easy, right? You'll be having a L-shaped scale. L-shape is the scale. ಆ ಎಲ್ ಶೇಪ್ ಸ್ಕೇಲ್ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ, ಒಂದಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಲೈನ್ ಪರ್ಪೆಂಡಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಸಿಕ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ ನಿಮಗೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ 90 ಡಿಗ್ರಿನ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಒ, ಯು ಟು ಲೊಕೇಟ್ 90 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ, ರೈಟ್? ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಒ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್, ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಟೂ ಲೈನ್ಸ್, ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ 90 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ 90 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಮಾರ್ಕ್. This is O, this is 90 degree mark. Join that and extend. Now this is GH. This GH is minor axis. ಇನ್ನೊಂದ್ಸರಿ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಹೇಗೆ ಮಾಡೋದು ಅಂತ. ಓ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಸಿಗುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಈ ಲೈನ್ಗೆ ಪರ್ಪೆಂಡಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಹಾಕ್ಬೇಕು, ಈ ಲೈನ್ಗೆ ಓ ಇಂದ ಪರ್ಪೆಂಡಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಹಾಕ್ಬೇಕು. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಮೇಜರ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಗೆ ಓ ಪಾಯಿಂಟಿಂದ ಪರ್ಪೆಂಡಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಓ ಪಾಯಿಂಟಿಂದ ಮೇಜರ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಗೆ ಹೇಗೆ ಪರ್ಪೆಂಡಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡೋದು? ಹೀಗೆ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಾ, ಈ ಮೇಜರ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಗೆ ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, 90 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ಮೇಜರ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಗೆ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಾಗಿ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಓ ಹತ್ರ 90 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ, ಅದನ್ನು ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಜಿ ಎಚ್ ಈಸ್ the minor axis. Let us measure the length of GH. This is 110 mm. Therefore, minor axis is 110 mm. This is